Good day to you from Chem Help ASAP. Let's discuss how alkenes and alkynes are both similar and different. On the surface, alkenes and alkynes have a lot in common. Both have the same characteristic feature, a carbon-carbon pi bond. An alkene has one, and an alkyne is blessed with a double portion, two C-C pi bonds. It would be natural to think that whatever addition reactions we learned on alkenes would also apply to alkynes. Unfortunately, it's not that straightforward. Let's look at the addition of HBr. In the top reaction, we are adding HBr to an alkene. We start by protonating the alkene to make a carbocation, the more highly substituted carbocation. The bromide then attacks the carbocation to complete the addition. I want to focus on the carbocation. This is the same kind of carbocation that we've seen over and over again. The carbon is sp2 hybridized, and we have a vacant p orbital. In the lower reaction, we seemingly do the same thing with the alkyne. Protonation forms a carbocation. This carbocation, however, looks different. Yes, the carbocation is sp2 hybridized, but the vacant orbital is instead an sp2 hybrid. Is this a problem? Yes, it is. These types of carbocations are especially unstable. I won't say they can't form, but they certainly do not react as predictably as the other carbocations. It's this kind of difference between alkenes and alkynes that makes addition reactions on alkynes less useful. Textbooks still talk about this chemistry, but in practice, aside from a couple reactions, addition reactions on alkynes are uncommon. The notable exception is hydrogenation, which we will cover in another video. So, while alkenes and alkynes share carbon-carbon pi bonds, alkynes do not undergo smoothly the same variety of addition reactions as alkenes.